Hello, my name is Olivier Notz and I'm responsible for the InterApp Academy. On this small how-to video, we will show you how to mount a gearbox on a Bianca butterfly valve. To mount the valve on the gearbox, we don't need a lot of special equipment. A key, the four screws, the gearbox and the valve. For the length of the screws, you can refer to the datasheet of the Bianca where you find the height of the top flange. And based on that, you see as well the pitch circle, the size of the screws. You see as well the valve is delivered in a pocket and you should not remove that plastic bag. Keep it always in the plastic bag. Furthermore, you see, I don't use a vise. I will not clamp the valve in the vise because the liner of the Bianca is very, very fragile. And if I use the vise the wrong way, I will damage the valve. And you see as well, I cover the working space with bubble packing foil to make sure the valve will not be as well hurt during the assembly. Important is to check the shaft size of the valve. It must correspond with the square in the gearbox. On the big sizes, we have a round shaft for the valve and for the gearbox. Place the valve on the gearbox. The shaft of the hand wheel should show perpendicularly to the pipe. As you can see now, the valve body stands not exactly parallel to the gearbox. This is because the valve is supplied in a semi-open position. It should remain in that position as well once the gearbox is installed, because so we avoid an unnecessary deformation of the liner during the storage time. So I turn now on the hand wheel until the holes on the valve neck correspond to the threads in the gearbox. And now I tight them properly. A large valve can logically be laid on the foil and you can use the tool that way if you need more force. The gearbox is adjusted from 0 to 90 degrees in factory and must normally not be adjusted. In case it would be necessary, you can adjust the throat limit screw at the closed position. To do that, you remove the cover cap, you untighten the counter screw, and with this headlet screw, you adjust the proper position, turning in or out corresponding to the position you want. Once done, you retighten properly the counter nut, and you cover the screw again with the cap. As you see, it is very easy to be done. Larger sizes need maybe to be handled a little bit differently, but in general, the process is the same. Thank you for watching this InterApp Academy video. I hope it is helpful.